Good morning everyone. So, welcome to the second day of using Linux tools. We had done until tab completion. Any quick questions so far? Yeah, yesterday we stopped and we did not keep any time for questions. We have time for a question or two now. Yeah, please ask now if you have any questions. Otherwise, we will continue with history. So, what is the slide? What does the slide say? Bash saves history of commands typed. Yeah, up and down arrows, up and down arrow keys allowed to navigate history. Ctrl-r searches for commands used. So, let us see this in little more detail. Yeah. So, let us look at all the commands that I typed. So, here pwd, ls, this is the directory we are in now. We can do up arrow mark one by one. Yeah. So, I am pressing up arrow mark and slowly navigating through all the commands I have typed, not just today after starting the computer, not just after opening this terminal, but they are all there in some particular file called dot history, dot bash history. So, this is all there in the history. This is in fact a command we had seen yesterday. Yeah. So, by up down arrow mark we can navigate, but then of course, if you think that you typed it only recently over the last 10 minutes, up down arrow mark will be helpful, but then what if you vaguely remember that paste, the last time I used paste is exactly correct. Yeah. So, you can press Ctrl R. Ctrl R is for reverse search. Now, on the command prompt we will type Ctrl R and then we type one letter P. The last command that had a P is pwd. We will continue to type A. Now, it says the last, it has already found paste word. Yeah. Now, it does not help to type paste anymore. If you type paste, the same thing will keep coming, S T E. Now, unless you type something else. So, please note on the screen whatever has come here, this corresponds to what you have typed. Yeah. And this particular pattern has occurred, for example, here. Yeah. That is why it has found this command for us. Has it executed it already? No, it has just found this. As soon as you are satisfied with this, press enter, then it will execute it. Yeah. So, what will it execute? We press Ctrl R, P A S. As you type more and more letters, it will keep looking for that pattern in the bash history. As soon as you are satisfied with what is coming on the screen, yeah, that this is indeed the command I had typed. These are all commands from your history. So, of course, when you search in your paste, this particular pattern may not come. So, yesterday you may not have typed precisely this, but something else. So, in your history what all commands are there, it will search through them and show you which is the recent most command that has this pattern. Which pattern? This particular pattern. Yeah. Once you have found it, you have brought it to the screen. Yeah. You can in fact, you can also make some small changes. Most of this is okay, but not marks1.txt, but marks.txt. Yeah. So, you can, once it has come on the prompt, you can also edit, make some small changes and then execute it. Yeah. So, please note that if it was remove something, then please do not blindly just type enter. You might have to make changes because that command will get executed again as soon as you press enter. Yeah. So, please use this very carefully. Any other, yeah, just like Ctrl R is for reverse search on the bash shell. So, this is all, what is it that we are talking about? Let us go back to the slides. This particular bash, what is it? This bash is the shell that we are working in, and this Ctrl R, up down arrow key, these are all features that bash provides for us. Yeah. So, bash is some easy interaction for us on this particular shell, on this command prompt, on the terminal. So another thing that we can know is Ctrl-l is for clearing the screen. You can use this even after you have typed something, you want to just take this to the top of the screen, Ctrl-l. Of course, you can also type clear, but to type clear you do not, you should not have any command on the, you should not have already typed any command. Clear has to be the only command you type here, but if you have typed something long, ls, and you have started typing something, after having typed something you prefer to make the screen clean, that whatever you have typed will remain like that. Press Ctrl L and it has gone to the top. Ctrl L is extremely helpful. It is something that bash provides for you to clear the screen. Clear is of course actually the command. If you have already typed something and you want to delete, if you want to delete the whole thing, are we going to press backspace one by one? We are looking for lots of keyboard shortcuts. So Ctrl U will clear the entire line. If you have typed something and now we want to take the last two words, why? Because this might be some big file name and we do not want to type it again, we have very carefully chosen this. So Ctrl W will remove the last line, last word, again Ctrl W will remove the last word. So these two words we have removed has got saved somewhere. Saved into some file? No, saved some buffer. Please do not ask me where is that saved. It is saved somewhere, it is useful to have it saved somewhere in some buffer. I will tell you how to retrieve it, that is the most useful thing. After we type something, something we had forgotten is supposed to be typed here perhaps, and we had typed something else, and now we very neatly did Ctrl W once, twice, and save two words into our memory, some memory. How will we reproduce it? Ctrl Y, we will put those two words back. In fact, if you do Ctrl U and remove the whole thing and then you type something else, again Ctrl Y will remove, will put back the entire thing you removed using Ctrl U. These are all different things to remember. At least this Ctrl U, Ctrl W, Ctrl Y has not been included in the slides. But then any typical bash help will provide all of this. If you are typing something, Ctrl C for cancelling. If you I was about to remove star dot star, instead of pressing backspace, Ctrl C will cancel that command, it will not execute it. Okay, so what are some shell meta characters? So the most of what we will spend today are more advanced things within bash. So the next thing we will see is something called meta characters. We already saw star as a meta character yesterday. So what are all these? This slash is a meta character. What is the importance of this meta characters? These all characters are not going to be taken literally as a character. If you want to create a new file with star inside that name of that file, with star as one of the characters, that is not allowed, unless you tell that this has to be taken literally. So these are all important meta characters which have some special significance, some special meaning. For example, slash we already saw was that if you have too much written on one line and you want to press enter but not execute it, that is when slash is helpful. Then greater than, less than sign we already saw. Exclamation mark is for pulling out something from the previously typed. If you already typed something, then exclamation will reproduce that same command. So dollar, what is dollar? We already saw that is how you extract out a shell variable. What is percent now? Somebody knows what percent? Okay, percent is something, and is for putting something into background. Star, the whole lot of things. Star is important for all of us to know. It can be any character there, any one character or more, no empty character. That is important to remember. Pipe we have already seen, open and close curly brackets are important. Open and close square brackets are also. Double quote we already saw. Open quote and close quote are important. They are different. Please note, open and close quotes have different meaning, very different meaning. So where are the two quotes now? Yeah, in typically in all Windows environment we use only one quote, the quote that is next to the enter command, the quote that is next to the enter command. Let me type here. This is what is vertical, it is so vertical, and whether it should be open or closed really depends on the context, that is fine, but not for Linux on the prompt. On the command prompt this is always going to be having a different meaning than another open quote, another quote which is just open quote. That one you will find above the tab key. Yeah, so please note this small difference. I can make this font even larger just for this purpose. So here is open quote, while here is a vertical quote. Yeah, vertical quote is what we will call closed quote, while this open one is one right above the tab key. So open is extremely different meaning compared to closed. Closed is the vertical one. Yeah, so even for LaTeX we have to pay attention to open and close differently, unlike Word or plain text where you can always use just closed quote. Since it is vertical people will understand from the context whether it is open or closed, but that is not the case in the environments. So what meaning does it have, we will see very soon. So star, so let us go back to the slides. Ls file dot star, star can be any extension now, at least one letter is required. Yeah, we will see an example here. So if only one character is there that is also okay, but at least one character is required. Yeah, so let us see more significance of the star and the open quote. So let's make a new file called touch file 4 dot touch file 4. Now let us see ls file 4, how many completions are there? When we press tab 2 times there is file, there is no nothing further, one option SCMI. Yeah, there are 4, there could be many more. Why don't we list all of these? Yeah, we press 2 tabs. When we press 2 tabs there are many completions, in all those many completions nothing further was included. Yeah, surprisingly. But when we do star includes no character also. Yeah, so star includes at least one character is required, was the best of my understanding. Okay, so let me take back my words. So when you take star, when you put star, no character is also allowed, it appears. Yeah, so that is certainly not the case in many other search patterns. So please always please note this star, whether it has to include some characters, any characters are allowed to be included there, any number of characters are allowed to be included there, but any number, whether 0 is allowed or not, depends on the context. Yeah, as far as ls file 4 dot star is concerned, no character there, meaning 0 number of characters is also allowed here, which was not the way I had understood so far, but then for some other places maybe 0 character is not allowed. Yeah, so you please pay attention to this particular star later on, we do not want later on some surprises, some unexpected surprises. So please note that star in many contexts requires at least one character. Star is 0 or more characters. Somebody has corrected from here, from IMCC Pune, that star is 0 or more character. Yeah, so that is what we are checking. But is so can I just request from IMCC Pune, that is that star 0 or more character in all the contexts, especially in the context of grep also? Yeah, if you know, please let me know, let us know on chat. We will just proceed to the next topic. Yeah, so please pay attention whether 0 number of characters also allowed or not in star is good to keep note. Another important, very important command is sort. Yeah, ls minus l. So why don't we see marks, students? These are the various students. Yeah, so clearly it's not sorted alphabetically. We might want to sort it alphabetically. Yeah, sort students. This has shown the output of the sorting on the screen. Yeah, the output has been spitted out onto the screen on the standard output. Standard output is screen, so what can the sort do? It will show it on the screen. If you don't want it to come on the screen, you can always redirect it. If it comes on the screen, that's extremely advantageous. Why? Because you don't need read write, you don't need write permissions in that directory where you're doing this text processing. After you know whatever is coming on the screen is correct, then you can always redirect it to a file you want, to whatever path you specify. Yeah, so coming on the screen is advantageous. If you see that it is sorted exactly the way you want, then you can always pipe it to another command, for example. Yeah, in this particular we can pipe it to something where, what example we can pipe this to? What, for example? Yeah, if you, for example, if you sort something and it's a very big file, then we can pipe it to less, to the command less, so that it shows one screenful at a time. Yeah, for example, we might cat marks1.txt students. After catting all this, we could sort it. Yeah, whether it makes sense or not to sort numbers and students, that's another issue. But you can sort it. After it is sorted, it might be much more than one screen full. You can then pipe it to less. Yeah, so this is how it is sorted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let us see. One can pipe it to less, and after you are satisfied with the output, you can always redirect it to a file. So why don't we copy marks? Another marks, yeah. Because I'm interested in explaining the significance of the n option for the sort command. Suppose we have these two extra columns, two extra rows. Zero has come on the top. Yeah, it has gone strictly by the fact that zero comes before 6, 6 comes before 7. The first letter, it is sorting according to the first letter, and sort is not trying to say 9 is more than 67. That is not the case. Yeah, so 0 of course is the first amongst these characters. 9, is 9 more than 89? Yeah. So what do we do? How do we try to say that sort by default means first column? Yeah, whatever comes first on the if we want it to go by the numerical value, so that 0 should not be the first. 0, 9, if it is there, it should go by the value of 9. Why? For example, you might have file sizes, you might want to sort according to file sizes, and then you want the value to be taken. Just because there is some 0 or 1 in the initial does not mean that the total value is less. Yeah. Similarly, some less number of digits, this is genuinely less than 67. Yeah. So we can do sort minus n for numerical value. So now it has shown both of these together. Yeah, of course, if the two if the two values are equal, it will show any one of them first depending on the particular algorithm. Yeah, now it has sorted based on numerical value. You could ask, can I sort based on numerical value of the third column? Yeah, so this has sorted based on numerical value of the first column, but clearly third column is not sorted. We might say that end semester marks, the final exam are very important. Let us sort all the students based on the marks they got only in the final exam, not based on the total. Yeah, so you can say sort minus k3 n. So what is this k3? K just tells that it is a third column. Yeah, after k means k, if you are putting k, yeah, all these letters are there in, if you see help sort. Now it is asking us to type all this. Yeah, now sort sort help has given us some man sort. Yesterday somebody had typed on Moodle how to quit out of man. So q is the command to come out of the man, because manual page is default using something like less, maybe it is using less itself. So now you can do man sort and see various options. K had better be here. It will tell according to this particular. You can also specify sort according to what key, equal to some key. Default is space character. Now you can also say then according to what particular. Now you should sort according to third column, first column, second column. These are different options one can give. So let us see. Sort is something we have already seen. We can also sort based on numerical value. You can specify a different delimiter using minus t option instead of space. Space is the default delimiter. Once you have specified the delimiter, you can specify which column, which field. These are also called fields. Which field to use? Yeah, on each line, these are different fields. They are nothing but different columns based on the delimiter here. Yeah, so delimiter d option in paste, but for sort it is a t option. Don't need to remember all this. All you have to remember is this is possible. Open man sort and find it out. You might also want to reverse the sort. Now instead of ascending, you might want descending. Then you can just put the r option. In whenever you are listing something, r will reverse the sort. Okay, reverse the listing. So we have a question from Mufakamja College, Hyderabad. So why don't we start and take the question? Please ask your question now.
Good morning, sir. Actually, two files are there. Using sort command, using two files can be sorting at a time.
Cat karke ya bina cat karke? Yeah, we heard your question. Your question was whether we can sort two files at a time. Yeah, whether the output is to be merged and then sorted, or the two files are to be sorted separately and separate outputs are required. That was not clear to us. If separate outputs are required, you have to do sort separately. If you want to combine the output and then sort, that is what we already did. Yeah, please come back to the terminal. So suppose we have students, cat students. Yeah, then we might have another file called, let's say, more students. So please, some of you had asked what editor to use. Vim is the editor we'll spend some time on later today. So please. So these are some different people, who have slightly different names. Yeah, Sven becomes Sen, suddenly he becomes an Indian person. So now cat students, cat more students, these are some more students. different students, yeah, please note spellings are different, students are different. We might want to sort together, so we can easily cat students, more students, we can cat all of them on the same, yeah. So if you are going to pipe it through sort anyway, see here the output is going to be piped. Whatever has come on the screen is the concatenation of these two. In what order you concatenate them doesn't matter. Why? Because you'll anyway pipe it to sort command. If you are piping it to sort command, it doesn't matter in what order you concatenate them. Yeah, when you now pipe it to sort, you have the two things sorted together, and of course these seemingly similar spellings are coming together. We only change some letter, not the first letter, and that is now the two things are sorted together. If you want to sort separate files, then we can just run the commands separately. If you want to run sort students, and now if you don't want to execute this, this will come on the screen. You can write this on a file, sorted students dot txt. Huh? Spelling mistakes in file names are okay. You can always do this, then you can do the next one. If you don't like doing one first and the then the other, you can also put semicolon here and type the other one, sort more students, yeah, and that the second one need not get redirected. So only the second one has shown on the screen, the first one has got directed to a particular file, which file, whatever file name we gave here, yeah. Both commands got executed in just one stroke, one enter stroke, because of this semicolon. The semicolon was one of the meta characters we did not spend time on. There are so many meta characters, yeah. So bash detailed help is available on the net. Our slides don't have detailed help. It is enough that we know these as far as our course is concerned. So that is how we can sort multiple files, multiple with or without merging them, depending on the requirement. Yeah. If there are any more questions, please use the hand raise button. We will go further. So reverse is for reversing the sort in many other, like in many other cases. So we will see now grep. So grep is the command we had to use grep yesterday, because many people had wanted to know how to cut a particular line instead of a particular column. So particular line removing is anyway far easier, yeah. One of the easy ways to do it is using grep, but then grep is not for removing just a line, it is far more powerful than that. What are its various usages? Grep is a command line text search utility. Yeah, it is a command for line search. So of course this example that is given here is rather long example. Yeah, let us see a simpler example. Let us see items. This is a particular file which we already opened once. Now we are interested in becoming politically more correct, maybe, and replacing all man by man slash woman. Yeah, why? Somebody might say, why should man month be counted only for man? Man slash woman. We are interested in all those lines where the word man occurs for various reasons. Yeah. So we are interested in searching for a particular pattern called man. And we want output as all those lines which have the word man, which have the pattern man anywhere in it. So how do we do this? Grep man items. So it has shown these lines having the pattern man. Incidentally, just like directory name was coming in blue color, that may not always happen. Here the actual pattern has come in red color. Please don't bank on this. Yeah, it may or may not come in red. What is important is it has outputted only that line which had the word man. There can be multiple occurrences on the same line, there can be multiple lines with the word man, they all will come on the screen. What about grep man? Here now something else has come, some journey man. So grep is very much case sensitive, by default it is case sensitive. The line that has actually come when you typed capital man has not come now, moreover some other word some other line had small m and that has come now. Yeah, if you want grep to ignore case, I now is not for interactive but ignore case. For man, now you can, yeah, it will show this. If you have decided to ignore the case, then whether you type capital M, yeah, M A, it will still show the same two lines. Why? Because this particular pattern, the case of all these letters in this pattern has been ignored. Yeah, so that is why both these lines have come. Please note what you type here is no longer important. The case of this is no longer important. So grep, we can use it for searching for a pattern inside every line. We can use it for many, many more things. Yeah, for example, we might do ls. One of the questions yesterday was, how do you look at all the files in not just current directory or subdirectory, its subdirectory, everything all together? Yeah, not just that, we might want to see their file sizes also. So that is something we will see little more detail. I think there is a find command inside the slides. So we will see how to find all subdirectories later on in this, in today only. But suppose we want to list minus l, we already saw list of star dot txt, but inside this whatever has come on the screen, we can grep it. So what has it done? So let me make the font size smaller just for a minute. Inside every line, wherever txt has come, it has shown that. Yeah, so this is how, this is almost like ls minus l star dot txt. Of course txt could have come somewhere else also, so we can do also ls minus l and pipe it to grep looking for pattern 1106. Yeah, so 1106 for example occurs here. It is whatever file was modified today, today 6 November. Yeah, this, it says all these files are modified today, last modified, created, they might have been created yesterday, but last modified is today, that is why that is a time stamp. So grep can be used very effectively with pipe. Yeah, whatever comes on the screen, you may first want to sort it. After it is sorted, you might want to look for a very specific pattern. Now for example, so what we are doing, whatever we are studying now is also called general regular expressions. Yeah, general regular expressions, to the best of my understanding, is extremely important in computer science language, in automata theory, in finite state automata. Yeah, in finite state automata, what all regular expressions, what is regular about it? I think some finite length words. But as far as we people who use Linux tools are concerned, general regular expression means just looking for this pattern. Patterns are small, finite length. For example, suppose we were looking for man inside which word? Items. Now we are, see, journey man, we might not be interested in the man word that occurs inside some other larger word. We might be interested only in the entire word man. Yeah, this is out of general regular expression will allow you to do all this. That space separates words, and we want man to have to be the beginning of a word or end of a word, which means it could be on the end of the line and have a space before, it could be on the beginning of the line. There are many such very special requirements we might want. How do we do that? Grep minus I, better to use a quote for all like this, I think. So now it will look for word man that occurs at the beginning of the word, because of whatever I have highlighted, man should occur also at the end of the word. Yeah, both are required. Now you might only be interested in one of them. As long as it occurs in the end of the word, it is enough, you might say. Now the journeyman also has come, luckily it was in the end of the word. Yeah, so now you might also be interested in grep, you might be interested in the word. Yeah, we might be interested in the programming word. Let's say grep for. Notice that you don't have to type fully. Yeah, if you are looking for programming pattern, you might look for just prog pattern. Prog will also be there inside programming. So it has shown all of these. You might say, no, we want only the programming that occurs in the beginning of the line. Only those lines which begin with the pattern. Yeah, you might want that. For some various reasons, who knows. So, we might say I want to put a begin character also there. Yeah, begin character, begin line character is not visible, but we want prog to be preceded by the begin line character. So, for that we will put a hat. So, now it has shown only those lines which begin with this. You might say anyway programming we do not have to type fully. We will type only ROG. Yeah, ROG is anyway there inside programming. Now, how will you specify beginning of the one? You want to say only now, will this okay? Will this be okay? No, there is this letter P. So, well, I am just spending one, some letter is allowed there. Yeah, so that letter, the dot means it can be anything, dot can be any one character now, neither 0 nor more. One dot means one character. Yeah, so any one character, and luckily all of them were happened to be P, capital P. So all these dot etcetera are extremely useful. In my just last 2 years, I have found lots of usage of dot, hat, end of the line character, all of these, and detailed help is available in help grep, in man grep. Let us see if something more about grep is written. Okay, I for case insensitive, minus V for reverse. Yeah, it will show if you want to see only those lines that do not have the search pattern you have given. Yeah, default grep will show you those lines which have the grep, have the search pattern. If you are now interested in only those lines which don't have the search pattern you have specified, yeah, then you will say minus V option. Yeah, to see everyone's marks except Anne's marks, for example. Yeah, that is when we can do all this. TR for translating or deleting characters, extremely useful. So TR comes from the takes its input from standard input, takes its output from standard output. Please increase font size. Okay, did I? Yeah, sorry. So, TR will make all capital to small, small to capital, it will allow replacing various things. Yeah, so dash is just a shorthand for saying all from A to Z, all the letters from A to Z should be replaced by capital letters from A to Z. Yeah, some nice notation rather than having to specify everything. TR will just translate. Minus S suppresses sequences of identical adjacent. Yeah, if there are multiple occurrences one after another, TR will remove them, TR will compress them into just one. Yeah, this will, for example, if you want to remove multiple lines, then slash n occurs multiple times, meaning empty lines, many empty lines are occurring together, that is when you can use suppress. TR could also help you to delete certain characters. Only a single character, yeah. So, please see this carefully. If you have some doubts, you can ask. We will spend some time on this, yeah. So, let us do like this, yeah. I hope all of you have downloaded this item test underscore files zip directory from Moodle. If you have not, just do like this slash etc slash password, copy as password file. Yeah, no need to go to Moodle now, download, just copy this. We want some test file to try out all this TR commands. Now, on this you try this TR, yeah, TR minus, let us see what this password is. Yeah, these are the different things there. TR minus C. C for complements, the first set of characters. We can do D to begin with. D and then delete a particular character. Yeah, let us see what this, what is there in this. Suppose you want to delete all colon character, yeah, or we want to replace colon character, tr cat and replace it with hash. So this has replaced all colons with hash. You can try to delete one some character while I just quickly come in a minute. TR can also help us delete various characters. It says we can also complement various characters. What exactly complement means? Try this out yourself, you will immediately know. We might want to remove all alpha non-alpha numeric characters. Yeah, we might want to remove alpha numeric characters, meaning what? You will only leave all the special symbols, colon, hash. Yeah, you want to remove all numbers, you want to remove all alphabets, but there are a whole lot of other symbols that you want to keep. Conversely, we might want to remove them, we might remove all this non-alpha numeric characters. This is how you can specify them, that is where square brackets are extremely important. Uniq, let us see the next command called uniq. What does this uniq do? It will uniq it. If there are multiple things, multiple lines which are repeated, they will get removed. Yeah, so after we sort, we might know that there are many guys' names are repeated. We will not know that these names are repeated until you sort them. Yeah, so let us see. So cat students. So here there are some two, there are some we created this list by catting the same file, so that is expected that they will be repeated, but they will not be occurring together, yeah, quite understandably. So we can, instead of piping it to less, we will pipe it to sort, they come together, then we can pipe it to uniq. Yeah, we could try to pipe it to uniq directly. Yeah, now it is not removed. Why? Because these multiple occurrences do not occur consequently, they do not occur consecutively. If they occur consecutively, only then they are removed by uniq. So if you want to remove it, then sort, you first pipe it to sort and then uniq it. Yeah. So incidentally, you may or may not want to sort something while doing uniq. If you want to do uniq with sort, then I happen to know that minus u option will also do it. In sort, often, very often we use sort and then uniq. That is why sort itself has given us this option minus u. But then let me tell you, there are many situations where we want to use uniq without sorting. Yeah, we want that if they are separately placed, they should be separately placed, still multiple occurrences have to be removed. That is also, yeah, and it will uniq it only if the entire line is the same. Just because first word is the same is not enough for removal of these multiple occurrences. Uniq minus u gives line which do not have any duplicate. Yeah, minus u will show you only those lines which are uniq to begin with. Minus d will show you those outputs which actually had duplicates. You can check whether this duplicate will also include triplicate 4 or not. This duplicate means multiple occurrences, I think, but you please check this yourself. Minus c displays the number of times each line occurs. Yeah, you might want to know that somebody has again typed the same thing. You want to know actually how many times this mistakes have been done. You want to know how many times this multiple occurrences have occurred. That is when the C option, yeah, it will count, C for count. Simple shell scripts. Any doubt so far? The next topic is going to take a lot of time. Okay, so simple shell scripts is the next topic we will see. Simply a sequence of shell commands in a file. Yeah, if you are going to do the same thing repeatedly again, why don't we type all these commands into a file and execute that file? And that file is like our command. Whatever command you want to type, you type it nicely into some particular file and run it from there. Yeah. So now I have to also tell you what editor to use. What editor to use for typing some command? For example, cat students. Minus u. This particular command is the first thing that we will first type into a file. Why? Because we might want to do this repeatedly. Again and again, somebody gives us some student's file, and we want to execute this. Yeah, and we want to also redirect it to something. Rather than it coming on the screen, we might want to redirect it to sorted, uniq file. Yeah. Suppose this is our objective, but we want to, each time somebody gives us a students.txt file, we do not want to again do this. Yeah. So, why do not we write this into one particular file? So, now you please do exactly what I am doing, just copy this. I assume everybody is using Linux, yeah, everybody is using Ubuntu Linux. In that, you just copy it like this using your mouse, then we will cancel this. We will not execute this. We have just copied all that into some buffer, some different buffer, yeah, by our mouse. You do not have to press Ctrl C or anything for copying. As soon as you copy it in your mouse, you have already, it is there in that buffer. How to retrieve it is what I will tell. Now you do nano catting dot sh. We are writing a simple shell script. For writing a simple shell script, we have opened an editor. This is the first time we are opening an editor in this course. So now we have opened an editor. We are free to type what we want. So we will go to the first line. It is default. It will open first line. And for those who have mouse with three buttons, press the middle button. For those whose mouse has three buttons, press the middle button. Where is the middle button for those whose mouse has only two buttons? Yeah, very few people know about this, surprisingly. You press both together, then it is like middle button. Yeah, so please press them, you press both together at the same time, then that will copy whatever you had carefully copied. It will paste whatever you had copied. This you have copied it. So this is, as you can see, this is too long. You can put this. I think this is the after you have copied this into this, you may or may not want to split it to two lines. If you keep it on one line, it's okay. Now we are going to quit out of this and come out. Yeah, how do you come out? Control X. It says at the bottom. See here, it says Control X for exit. When you are exiting, it will ask you whether you want to save or not. Let's save it. It will now, because they are trying to exit, it is saying, do you want to save or not? You press yes now, and it will ask you default. Is this the file name you want to save? Yeah, we started with this file name. Why don't we continue with the same file name? Okay. So we have now created a new file called catting.sh. How did we type this? All this, we opened it into an editor, into the nano editor. In the nano editor, we did not type everything because we are all very lazy. We copied everything using the mouse and then we pasted it. For those of you who have three mouse buttons, middle button will paste it, and for those of you whose mouse has only two buttons, pressing both together typically will make it like three mouse, like the middle button of a three mouse. So let us see whether we have really succeeded in typing properly or not. Yeah, so you please put cat. Show it on the screen. You can also see less. Okay. So now whatever command we are supposed to execute, that has all come into one file. Now we want to learn how to execute this file. Yeah. This is only our command now. We have created a new command by combining some old commands. Cat was a command. We piped it to sort with some option u. All that, whatever is seen on the screen, yeah, up to here. This Ctrl C is because I cancelled it. Yeah, I press Ctrl C to cancel it. I didn't execute it. So if this is a command, why don't we execute it? Catting.sh. Why don't we? Catting.sh command not found. It doesn't know that catting.sh is a command. Yeah, you decided it to be a command. You opened an editor and typed everything. But how does this shell know that this is supposed to be a command? So we will. So default commands are found in some long path. Every word you type, it will look for that particular file in some big path. How to find how to see what that path is, we will see very soon. So now we have to tell our script that that catting file is kept here only in the current directory. So why don't we type this? This we are telling where that command is. It could not find it. Now we are telling it. Yeah. So we try to execute it now. We are trying to execute this particular file. So I request all of you to try this. Try to execute it and be told that the permission is denied. Yeah. Then that is. Then we'll do whatever is to be done next. We'll do after that. So we have another question from Periyar Manamai, Tanjavur.
Difference between approps and grep.
So the question from Periyar was, what is the difference between apropos and grep? See, grep is for looking for a particular pattern inside a file. It is something completely. We know we want to look for a pattern. In what file do we want to look for the pattern? In the file that we will specify to grep. Apropos is totally different. If you think there is some command that day in that course, in SDES course, we were told of some command which is for searching regular patterns. Yeah, did it start from G or that uname, for example? I was telling it starting from U, but what is that command for? What for setting permissions? So permission is the important word. Then you will say apropos permissions. Apropos permissions, when you do, it will tell you various commands which all have permission word inside its help page. Yeah, I think it will have permissions word inside the what is page. So apropos is for looking in more detail about all the commands that have some specific word, and you might know only that word. Yeah, if you know for uniq, for removing multiple occurrences, uniq was the command. But this uniq, how will you remember? It is not even the correct English spelling. Unique is the actual English spelling, but now these people have made a different spelling. You might want, you don't have to remember all these different wrong spellings. Yeah. So you will say apropos. Apropos you have to remember, unfortunately. Yeah. Apropos uniq. It will tell you all these commands have something to do with uniq. Are surprisingly uniq word itself is not there. Huh? Okay, so the question was, what is the difference between apropos and chat? In that context, we started seeing that grep is for a very specific purpose, that you want to search for a pattern inside a file. That is when you will say grep pattern file. Yeah, this is a general regular expression. For finding a regular expression inside a file. Instead of searching in a file, you can also pipe that file information through a pipe. As the output of another command, you can give it to grep. Of course, but pattern, of course, you have to type. Now, on the other hand, apropos is different. Apropos is for a very specific purpose. It is, if you vaguely remember that some particular we were told about some command for removing directory. For removing directory, what was that command? RM are all short forms. Surely we are not obliged to remember short forms. Yeah, it's enough that we know what is the command for removing. Remove. Yeah. So why don't we do apropos remove? It will tell us all this and says, oh yeah, RM is the one. Apropos is for that purpose. It's a different purpose. Yeah. Now, for example, yeah, for uniq, I propose. What was the command for uniq? Was it uniq? Yeah, we say uniq. uniq some file marks1.txt. Yeah, the uniq is not even there. It says we after a few days you will have forgotten that uniq command. How do you find out what is that command? You say apropos uniq. We hope uniq is there inside this list. Yeah, is it there inside that list? Oh, last one is there. Last, yeah, so uniq word is there. So this is the word that we were looking for. Apropos is for that purpose. The purposes are clearly different. And grep is for searching for a pattern inside a file. Of course, instead of searching in a file, you can pipe that information through as output of another command. So we had been writing a particular command inside a file, and then we are trying to execute that. When we are trying to execute that, I hope everybody has tried to do this. It says permission denied. That is because, let us see, ls minus l catting says it is only read and write permission to the user, no execute permission. Yeah, if you have not given execute permission for yourself, and then if you try to execute this as a command, yeah, so please note there are other ways of executing this sh file. Here the way it is written, the first thing that comes is command. We are now trying to execute this as a command, yeah, so we should give execute permission to this file. So for those who already practice that other number way of giving permissions, 700 will give execute permission. Yeah, you might also want to say chmod. For those who please don't ask questions about 754 now, because we already saw this other way, user plus execute for catting. Any one of these two commands is enough. Yeah, I am typing both for those of you who know only one of these. Now let us see ls minus l. Yeah, so notice that it has given execute permission. Further, it has changed the color also. This also we noted yesterday. Now let us see this upper thing. Yeah, so now it says there is some error. Except for that error, it has executed. For those of you who would have put it in one line, for them it would have executed. So what we have to now go and see is this particular symbol was not supposed to be that, it was supposed to be this character. Yeah, so now again we have opened nano, we have made that small change. Now let us execute it. So now it has executed fully. To execute fully means what? It has recreated this sorted uniq file. This file has got created by execution of catting.sh. Now whatever you wrote inside that has got executed. What got executed? This particular command has got executed. Yeah, so this is what we will call a shell script. Now it is convention, it is good to write. You might be exchanging this catting.sh with various people, so it is good to write, sorry, it is good to write on the top. This to say that, sorry, not pipe, exclamation mark. It is important, sometimes it is important to write this. If you are working in bash, it is not compulsory. If somebody is going to try to execute this in bash, it is not compulsory. But somebody else, you might give this. There are various shells. Bash is just a very popular shell. There is some C shell, there is a plain shell, just sh, there is a K shell, there are TCSH, yeah, TCSH is another shell. Different people will be exchanging this. So for other shells, it is really required that you write this on the top. Yeah. So inside the bash script itself, inside the bash script, comments are written like this. Comments. These lines are not executed. Yeah, but the first line is telling that you are going to write a bash script. So please note that for us it doesn't matter. Why? Because we will always be executing in bash only. This line doesn't matter. And if you want to write comments, please write hash in the beginning, whatever, not just in the beginning, whatever is written after the hash on each line, that will not be executed. That is like comment of that line. If hash is the first letter that comes on a line, then that entire line is comment. So again we are saving this and quitting and coming out. Yeah. So are there other ways of executing this? Somebody has written on chat, sh catting.sh will also do this. So why don't we, what, let's do like this, where if the file is executing, we are not able to see that it has executed. Why don't we remove that? Why don't we make this change? We go there and remove this. Why? Because it is writing to a file, it is executing and nothing is coming on the screen. Now because we have removed that redirect, it will come on the screen. So when it is executing, we will know, look, it has executed. Yeah. So this is our catting file. Now it has executed this. Executed means what? From here to here output has come. Yeah. Now are there other ways? Yeah. If permissions are not given, yeah, it might turn out that you are not the owner of that file. Yeah, you might have gone to somebody's directory and you want to execute the file there, and you don't have, you are not the owner of the file, you cannot change the permission. So source catting.sh will also execute it without execute permission. Yeah, now the command is source, it will just execute this. The source is a very useful thing for .bashrc, for example. .bashrc is not a command, but you want to still execute it. That is when dot is, that source is required. Also dot does the same thing. I don't know what is the exact difference between source and dot. In all the usages it behaves the same way. Some such things are not there in the slides, but sh, somebody told, I didn't know about this, sh catting also does the same thing. Yeah, good to know. Maybe in that case bash also might do. Bash will also execute the bash script cutting.sh. So let us see some more complicated shell scripts. Yeah, this is, as of now we use this just as a shortcut. You write it each time to execute is easier now. Yeah. Now, but of course, what each time when you want to execute, each time this file name, important information has to still be in this file name. Yeah. Just for example, it happens to be the same file. But what if different files, you do not want each time to specify in the same file. Yeah. So these are things we will see next. So we already saw about the permission giving, etcetera. Now shell variables. Yeah. So now let us see this particular script. So name equal to fossee. So this dollar is different from this dollar. Yeah, this dollar is a prompt. Yeah, so on my computer, let me change the prompt so that it is not confusing anymore. You can also try this. Yeah, so ps1, why don't we put ps1 equal to hash greater than. Yeah, we will put one space. If you are going to put space inside the prompt, then you have to put close quote. Each time it is close quote only, open quote has a very important different meaning. What is its meaning? We have not seen yet, we will see later. So from now on, this is my prompt. Yeah. Why? Because we do not want this dollar. This dollar is almost suggesting it is some shell variable or something. So we have changed our prompt, but in the, when the slides are made, there is this dollar. Let us go back to the slides. There is this dollar. This dollar is certainly very different from this dollar. What does this do? Name equal to fossee, count equal to word count minus l, wonderland.txt. Yeah, it will execute this. This, please note that this particular quote is open quote. This is a quote sitting above the tab key. This is different from close quote. The close quote is the vertical one. The vertical one is the one we used to modify our prompt. For those who are not interested in modifying the prompt, don't worry about it. modifying the prompt is not so important. Close quote is different from open quote. Here we have open quote. So whatever you put in between two open quotes, yeah, we start with open quote, we also end with open quote. Yeah, might seem contradictory. Here also we have the same key above the tab key. Here also we have open quote. Whatever is between open quotes is executed, and the output of that is assigned to the variable count. Yeah, so count is some variable we are introducing. What is getting assigned to that variable? You can assign some number to it. For example, name is another variable we have assigned fossee to it. Instead of fossee, if you want the output, yeah, you let us do this. What does it say? Name equal to fossee. How do we see whether this has succeeded or not? Echo. Sorry, echo name. Tab key should work. That is how you will know there's a mistake. So name, what is out? What if you want to read out the value of a particular variable? Then you have to use dollar. Yeah. If you say echo just name, it will echo. It will echo will whatever you type on the screen. It will echo. Whatever you type on the after the echo, it will just put it on the screen. But we are not interested in actually name. We want to see the value of the variable name. For that, we'll put dollar. Yeah. Now, for count, count equal to what do we want as a value? Word count minus L. L perhaps is only the number of lines. Wonderland. What has got assigned to count? Let us see this command first. Word count minus L wonderland.txt. This has told us 4047 wonderland.txt. And this is the output of the command word count minus L wonderland.txt. That output, instead of making it come on the screen, we have assigned it. Equal to is assigning whatever is after the equal to sign into count. But is it going to assign literally this? No, because this is open quote, this is sitting above the tab key. Because it is open quote, it will get executed. Whatever is between open quotes will get executed. After it is executed, what had come out? This whole thing had come out. This whole thing will get assigned to the variable count. Yeah. How do we see that? Count, it will just echo count. It does not know you are interested in the value of the variable count. Echo. Yeah. So that particular output has got assigned to count, and we are indeed able to see it. You might want to say, no, I was interested only in the number 4047, yeah, not in this word. So why don't we pipe it? Okay, sorry, why don't we do this more slowly? Let us go back to this using up arrow key here, and we want cut delimiter minus F1. Yeah, only the number 4047 has now come. Why? Because we have removed the second column, wonderland.txt, we do not want. Yeah, we only want 4047. So this particular value we can assign to count. Now echo count. Yeah, so bash, with bash you can do a whole lot of programming also. Yeah, we are going to of course do much more amount of programming, that is why we will teach Python. But with bash you can do many such, evaluate various things, get it, you can actually add these numbers. Yeah, just like we multiply add in simple programming languages, this is possible in bash also. Somebody is saying video is not available, that might be a bandwidth problem. Okay, so please note, come back to the slides, please note that there should be no space before or after the equal to sign. In Python we will certainly like to keep a space for better readability, but now in bash it had better not be there. All text following the hash is a comment. Echo command just prints the output. Yeah, so make directory this. You can do this, and it will. You can also type all this into a particular file and execute it. So whatever is written here can be put into a file and can be executed. Yeah, I can encourage you to try it, but no need to do now. Somebody is asking me to repeat the prompt change. Prompt change is not important. Yeah. Anyway, all this is recorded. You can do up arrow mark key. You can see it later. We will not repeat that part.